Well, there's one bit of future tech we've been promised for years, and our next guest is racing to make it a reality. The flying car. That's what Woburn, Massachusetts startup Terrafugia is working on. Are they flying cars? Are they drivable planes? How will they be regulated? And how soon will it be before the rubber no longer meets the only the road? To answer that and more, I'd like to welcome Chris Geran, CEO of Terrafugia. Welcome.
Thank you.
So, first flying car to the market, you're still aiming for that?
We should be delivering our first products to customers the middle of next year.
And what are they like? Are they a driving plane or are they a flying car?
Yes, that particular product has wings that fold up. So you park it in your garage, you drive it to the nearby airport, unfold the wings in less than a minute and take off to wherever you want to go.
How do you ensure that the pilot is harnessing safety, is focused on safety going forward? Because this is a whole new area that needs to be regulated.
Is it interesting? Because we're a flying car, we have to meet the regulations about the National Highway Safety Transportation Group, as well as the FAA. So the person who's driving obviously has to be a licensed driver in the U.S. And when they're behind the stick, when they're flying the vehicle, they have to be a licensed pilot with the FAA. But we build in the safety aspects, and it's a bit of a challenge for us because we need to have all of the automobile safety aspects, seat belts, airbags, crumple zones, right? All of that stuff is part of our testing process and a requirement for us. And when you're in the air, we need all the things to go with that, including a parachute. So if there's trouble in the air, the last resort is to pull the parachute and come straight down and land safely. So
how are the regulators about all of this? Is it easy to negotiate with them? Are they looking forward thinking?
You know, we were one of the first to be in this space, and we'll certainly be the first to have a roadable aircraft, right, a flying car that's in production. So there were some challenges along the way. And in some cases, we need to get the regulators to compromise. For instance, an aircraft windshield is an acrylic piece of equipment, and an automobile one is safety glass. But if a bird strikes the windshield when you're in flight, the safety glass makes it so that you can't see. So we needed to have the FAA and the highway safety folks compromise to allow us to use an aircraft quality windshield in an automobile, and they did.
We're seeing pictures of the vehicles that you've been making. The transition, I believe, is the one that's coming on tap as soon as next year. But what about the TFX aircraft? This was one that goes far faster, far further. How does that change the whole rules of transportation?
So in that case, it's a much different design. And in fact, for that design, it's a tilt rotor kind of vehicle. Right? So it's a different development. It's actually much more challenging to come up with that one. And honestly, what we've done now is we've decided that the second product we will produce is going to be an urban air mobility vehicle, a flying taxi, in effect. Right.
Okay.
So we've sort of put the TFX, the small tilt rotor vehicle, on the back burner for the time being, because we see a real market opportunity with urban air mobility.
And this is you've just been to the Elevate event that
That's
Uber
right.
put on. I mean, this is getting a crowded space now.
It is. I think we're in a unique position. Right? At the top of this space are Boeing and Airbus.
Yeah.
And they're clearly excited and interested that this is likely to be a new market for them. So they've actually acquired some of the startup companies, and they're fully funding them. At the other end of the spectrum, there's lots of small companies that are startups that struggle for funding every year. We find ourselves in a different situation, right? We're now owned by the largest manufacturer of cars in China, who are fully funding us, but we don't have the other aspects of the big companies like Boeing and Airbus. So we're very agile.
So you can be nimble. Geely, the Chinese company putting the money in, how much money does this take?
It's in the hundreds of millions of dollars in order to get you fully developed into this process.
Right? What about autonomous? When is that a focus?
So it's different for cars and aircraft, but in some aspects similar. Both have been under development for a long time. So what we're doing is we're actually taking an approach that says we're going to start with pilots in the air vehicle, right? Something that the FAA can certify immediately, that we could put into production and into the airspace right now. But with the aspects of autonomy in the vehicles so that you can start to demonstrate that capability. And when the FAA is ready to accept that, or the other agencies around the world, then we can take the pilot out. So in order to get into the market, we're taking a bit of a different approach. Our urban taxi is a 4-passenger and 1-pilot vehicle. And when we're ready, we'll pull the pilot.
A date for when that will come on tap?
we'll be flying the first prototype next year. And we're looking to deliver around 2023.